Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Romans 12:3-8. For by the grace given me I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment, in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you. For just as each of us is one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ we, though many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts, according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give generously. If it is to lead, do it diligently. If it is to show mercy, do it cheerfully. Today's title is One Body with Many Members. The human body is a wonder for many. It has the mastery of beauty with the best possible functionality. We can't normally have these two together even in this modern scientific age. We, humans, have to sacrifice either beauty or functionality. But God has it all in us. What's more amazing in human body is the coordination of each different part of the body. Without even consciously thinking, each body parts work together for a common purpose. The harmony of all parts of the body and the balance between each body part is seamlessly beautiful. Even God who created it loves it and adores it. How beautiful you are, my darling. Oh, how beautiful. Your eyes behind your veil are doves. Your hair is like a flock of goats descending from the hills of Gilead. Your teeth are like a flock of sheep just shorn, coming up from the washing. Each has its twin, not one of them is alone. Your lips are like a scarlet ribbon, your mouth is lovely. Our temples behind your veil are like the halves of a pomegranate. Your neck is like the Tower of David, built with courses of stone. On it hang a thousand shields, all of them shields of warriors. Song of Songs 4:1-4. We ourselves also often wonder about it. But there is another body as beautiful and mysterious as our bodies. That is the church that the apostle christened as the body of Christ. It has the same mysterious beauty and functionality. It also has wonderful coordination between different members of the body. For just as each of us is one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ, we, though many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. A church has many members in one body like a human body. Each member of the body contributes to and supports the other. God loves the body of Christ and joyfully blesses it. I am sure that Psalm 133 clearly shows the joy of God looking down on the body of Christ where many brethren of God gathered in unity. How good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. It is like precious oil poured on the head, running down on the beard, running down on Aaron's beard, down on the collar of his robe. It is as if the dew of Hermon were falling on Mount Zion. For there the Lord bestows his blessing, even life forevermore. Psalm 133:1-3. You will be blessed if you are in the body of Christ, which is the gathering of spiritual brothers and sisters in God. That's why a church is so special and crucial in the Christian life. As you can't have salvation apart from Christ, so you can't have spiritual blessings of God apart from the body of Christ. Are you a member of the body?